Hi. We've come to kill you. Time to die. Thank you. Ooh, Dragon's Moor Shield? The Elder one must have been holding that. Ooh, it's a bindable thing. Binds with Fighter or Barbarian. A Barbarian likes to use two-handed weapons, though. Bind this item to unlock the next level. Exceptional. Plus 8 shield deflection. Grants bash. This shield was traditionally passed between dragon hunters to honor exceptional feats and skills. Receiving the Dragon's Moor Shield is one of the highest honors among dragon hunters. And over the years, it's been the object of countless bets, soured friendships, lifelong apprenticeships, and violent deaths. Wow. Well, we just gotta have this thing then. Let's put these traps away. I tend to find a lot of those. When do we get this? Grants solitary? Plus one enemies needed to flank. Immunity paralyzed. 25% of damage range guaranteed for 3 seconds. Requires no allies in radius fast. You can't be flanked and you can't be paralyzed. I don't know when we got this. Might have been from previously. White March Part 1. The Comtessa of Minetti was pledged to the Marchese of Veralta, but her heart belonged to her captain of the guard. When she learned that her love meant to challenge the Marchese for her affections, she enchanted this gauntlet to protect him during the duel. When the young captain threw it at the Marchese's feet, the two men drew swords and fought across the grounds of the Marchese's palace. Whenever they sparred near the fallen gauntlet, the captain had the upper hand. Yet every time the young captain drove the Marchese back, the tide turned. Eventually, the captain caught wise. He allowed the Marchese to press him once more. As they passed the fallen gauntlet, he threw his strength into one final onslaught, winning the duel and the hand of his beloved with his blade at the Marchese's throat. Well, gauntlets. Goes there. Of deflection, plus 9, though. Gauntlets of swift action. Attacks faster. Gloves of manipulation. Always good for a thief. Gauntlets of accuracy. Plus 5 accuracy. And she's got gauntlets of accuracy as well. I'm gonna give Palagina these things. That brace or whatever. Soulbound scepter. See, he's got the soulbound greenstone staff, so we're gonna put this away. Do we all have soulbound weapons? Unique flail. This is a small shield. Blade of the Endless Paths is pretty sweet. St. Edward's Redeemer. Palagina has a soulbound thing. So I don't want to give her that sword. He's not using a... I mean shield. She's not using a shield. The only one who uses a shield now is Thiadess. It's a small shield. And where is this thing? can only stack 5. Moderate, light, critical, major. Here's critical. Oh, we can't stack them. Moderate. Off screen, I'll have to, like, try to match this stuff up. Make some room. It's a ray of fire. Cares about flame, fan flames, isn't that good? What is this? Crackling bolt? I love the sounds everything makes, just like Baldur's Gate and those games. They all have their own little special sound when you move them around. Fireball. Do we have a fireball one? Rolling flame. Hmm. Anyway, where is this thing? The shield. Who has it? Of will plus 9 is pretty sweet. Goes, yeah, in that item. I'll put that away for now. He has it. It's a medium shield. So since she doesn't have... This is not a soulbound thing. Eight deflection, retaliation. The only bad thing is because you're going medium, you get a penalty to accuracy. But deflection is great. We get bash. And plus one enemy is engaged. Alright. We'll do that. I'll keep this. Just in case. And where is it? Is she holding it? Did I give it to her? No. We still sorry guys. He still has it. Nice! Look at that thing. Cool. Alright. Bind the soul. Oh, only a fighter and barbarian. Sheesh. Well, my fighter and barbarian aren't using it. Is it worth it? Damn it. Well, let me just try it. I'll keep that in inventory in case I want to switch back. In case all of a sudden fights start sucking.
No problem.
Oh, that's to control that. Let me just look around.
Light, flame, and sound.
And sneak.
We'll keep to ourselves.
Mm-hmm. Oh, missed something. Can't forget that one scolder ear. So this is back where we were. Pretty cool. This is the entire area. Alright, Durance.
Hmm?
Do your magic. Cool. You turn the wheel, and a gust of steam blasts you in the face. You stagger back and fall, spiraling towards smoke and flame. That's not good. You find solid ground beneath your feet, even as the air around you is a haze of smoke and heat shimmer. Coughing, you bat acrid fumes away from your face. It was the sound of the watcher, you know, power for a second. As you acclimate to the soot-choked air, you see flames leaping in the distance. Each flare bathes you with warmth, and even as you struggle to pick out the details of this place, something about it seems familiar. Let's examine our surroundings. You can see little through the thick smoke, but the dancing flames illuminate a dragon's head, cast in stone. It's the White Forge. Yeah, I figured it was using the power from the White Forge. Oh, what the hell? As you start toward it, something massive comes crashing down in front of you. You leap back at the sound of metal slamming into metal and feel a deep tone ring through the thick air. Recovering your bearings, you find yourself looking at an enormous hand. It's dark and shiny with heat, but you see every bone, muscle, and tendon working in harmony beneath the bronzed flesh. The hand's owner is hidden behind clouds of smoke, but the hand itself is wrapped around a pole as thick and sturdy as a tree trunk. Follow the arm. You try to follow the arm to its owner, but the heat and smoke overwhelm you. You turn back. Okay. Follow the pole. Is this one of the gods or something? You continue onward to see what lies at the other end of the pole and what's responsible for the clangorous music. Just as the hand rises again and smites you down, everyone dies. The end. It swings down in a perfect arc. A tower of metal smashes down ahead of you, raining sparks and glints of essence as another deep ringing note sounds. You realize that you're looking at an enormous hammer. The head glows with heat and essence, though the purple luster fades as the soul energy is sucked from the hammer and into the work under it. Let's get a closer look at the work. As the hammer rises once more, you dart forward to see what lies beneath it. Hannah squashes you. What the hell? What is that? A lone figure sprawls on an expanse of steel as smooth and broad as lake ice. The figure itself is enormous. A what? A magefolk of twisted flesh and forged metal. Its arms end in two spiked clubs, and its head is a blunt, eyeless wedge. Those eyeless things I heard about. New big monster for this expansion, DLC, what have you. It opens its mouth and keens. The desperation in that noise reminds you of a newborn's fear and confusion. Air rushes at your back. You look up and see the hammer, its head once more glowing with essence, speeding towards you. Time to move. You awaken to the sensation of warm tiles beneath your face. You are prone before the boiler, which drones on, pushing heat through the tower floor. But in the vapor that pulses from the power and the boiler and pipes, you smell the fumes of the White Forge. Cool. I activated a boiler atop the western tower that keeps the cannons warm. When I did, I had a vision of someone, Abaddon, I think, constructing a magefolk of metal and flesh at the White Forge. Wengra is waiting to hear that the west tower is safe and that the cannons are ready.
That's rather dramatic.
Yeah, sorry, you know, happens sometimes.
Eh?
Oh, I can look at this. Engravings depict the Pargrun's journey to the White March. Alright.
No problem.
Time to go. Our skull's waiting for us by the stairs, which I hardly ever use. We need to get back down below and talk to, Wagra, whatever the hell her name is. How do I do this again? Oh, it's here. Go to the front gates. Hey, hey. How's your leg? Alright, where is she? Oh. We were covering her. Wengra is her name.
That was incredible! Whole Forge spit flames when you did whatever you did. And the smoke! Ha! I saw it from here!
Got experience.
And now to see about these cannons.
She rubs her hands together. She starts for the door, but then she remembers something.
This is for you. Found it while we were cleaning out the battery.
Well, thanks. I'm assuming that's some copper or something. I have a few questions for you. What's on your mind? How do these cannons work?
Ugh, if only I could show you.
She frowns.
But everyone else is all worried about accidents and injuries. So they've said I can't fire them until there's a real need.
Yeah. Alright, farewell.
I'm headed up the tower. Gonna make those cannons shine.
She's so happy. She skips toward the door. Cool. We have another quest, though, don't we? Meet Nesta at the White Forge. We were just there, I didn't see her. Go to the White Forge. Okay. Where's Nesta? White Forge keeps you warm. I was supposed to meet her here. And I'm not seeing her. Oh, there she is. She might probably stand there the whole time, just look, blends in with everybody here. It's a worker? Yeah. So this is the fabled White Forge. Very impressive. I know several smiths in Crucible Keep who would dearly love to be standing where I am right now. How long were the souls of those Pragrunin bound here anyway? Centuries? Releasing them back to the wheel was probably for the best. Yeah, I kinda think so too. These smiths working the forge, though, what are their qualifications? Who trained them? Surely the forge isn't being used as effectively as it could be. I think it would be more profitable for everyone if Crucible Keep trained smiths... If Crucible Keep trained smiths were brought in to run things here, wouldn't you agree? Why do you guys gotta try to take everything over? I agree, Star would prosper even more. Two seems good. Oh, that's true. I believe this is true. The White Forge only works for descendants of dwarves from the battery. You knew that, right? What? Really? I guess that does make sense. I'll make sure to pass that along. All that's left to do is write up a draft of the trade agreement with the terms and conditions we've agreed upon and present a copy to Tarfos. It'll still be a few months before the final agreement can be signed, but we've made great progress here. She bows. I appreciate the escort, Thiadess. Farewell. I'm not going back to stalwart yet. Return to Tarfos. I negotiated a rough draft of the trade agreement with Nesta. Tarfos will be eager to hear how things turned out. He should still be waiting near the mines in Stalwart. Okay. Is this where we have a thing? Yeah, we can take that. There's another one somewhere around here. It's not here. It's upstairs. So instead of buying things and returning, it's in that room. Oh, how do we get up here? Oh, this. Okay. It's in here where we were naughty. Probably turned ourselves to lawful evil or catechism. Oh. Can we all go? Cool. Now we are full of camping supplies. And we're a little banged up. Just a tiny bit. We don't really need to be resting. So far, I gotta say, guys, I'm really, really enjoying this expansion. And I'm gonna call it an expansion because it's more than a DLC in a way, isn't it? Kind of like the old expansions, the expansions of old, whatever you want to call it, whatever juxtaposition you want to put expansion and old. It's just that's how it is. So. The foundry. Is the foundry a separate place? Oh, they mean that's underneath. Because next I want to go to Whitestone Hollow. We have a quest to do there, and it's a whole new zone to explore. Let's just run down here. Before I return to Stalwart Village, we'll solve that other quest and explore that zone. At some point, we gotta go back to Crucible Keep to help this smith, this female smith. We got bounties to do, too. Whitestone Hollow. Searing Falls. Oh, that's way back. Okay. That's back in the main, you know, I'm not gonna say continent area. I don't know. Whitestone Hollow again. Return to Tarfos. These we can't do. Alright, Crucible Keep. So let me just look. If I go straight, Durgan's battery to the foundry. I don't remember the foundry. Oh god. Sheesh. Alright, guys. The foundry is the White Forge. Why don't you call it the White Forge and not the foundry? So anyway, next episode we're going to go into that Whitestone Hollow next episode. So, stay tuned for that. I'll leave this place off screen and so you don't have to watch me wandering around. Thanks so much for watching. Enjoying greatly much the little text, you know, adventures kind of thing. Not like a text adventure, it's like a choose your own adventure kind of thing. I always love those, and I didn't think there was nearly enough of that in the main game anyway. And it was a little bit more in the White Forge, the White March part one, and it looks, it's at least so far, unless they're putting them all in the beginning, it looks like so far there's even more in part two. Enjoying, and of course the new characters, the new voice acting is awesome. Still think there could be a little more of it, but there's plenty of it, more than in the main game so far at least, so which is always good. And yeah, interesting stuff. Interesting. Guess I. It was cool to go back and check out at least part of the Durgan's Battery again, although we missed some floors. I would have liked to walk through, you know, the other areas where, like, the Forge Master's quarters were and all that stuff. Where we fought endless enemies in that area, so I guess they felt like it was, there was no real sense in putting that back in, since you're just gonna wander around and talk to people. I would love to do that, though. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and endure. In enduring, go strong.